What's a Cologuard?
So Cologuard is a new catchphrase. It's a relatively recently developed test that carries the original idea of measuring something in the stool to detect colon cancer, which we used to do as a hemocult to look for blood in the stool. And now it takes it a step further and it looks for other factors that you might find from colon cancer. In this case, basically multiple targets for DNA. So you're looking for DNA from cells that might exist in a colon cancer that have been shed from the cancer into the stool and then measured on a stool sample that the patient would provide.
So to me, this is a big difference from doing a colonoscopy looking for polyp, removing the polyp. Here you're really looking for the shedding of a cancer that's there and it's in the stool and you find it and then you know you got to go look.
Correct.
Is that correct?
That's correct. And so anybody that submits a stool Cologuard sample and has a positive result then has to follow that with an attempt at a colonoscopy to look for potentially a cancer or a polypoid lesion that needs to be addressed.
To me, it looks like the horse is already out of the barn. You know, you've already got the cancer there. If you find a positive specimen on a Cologuard, that means perhaps you didn't have a colonoscopy when you should have, or something along that line. Now, how good is a Cologuard?
So Cologuards are fairly accurate, and respectably speaking about the stool collection process, they have very good data backing them from that standpoint. If you're not going to directly look at the colon and you're going to do an indirect test, they're reasonably accurate. We know from large studies that have been published that there is about a 7% false negative rate.
False negative rate.
So that means that if you have 100 patients that are diagnosed with colon cancer and they all had a Cologuard at some point beforehand, in 93 of them, their Cologuard would have been positive, leading ultimately to the diagnosis of colon cancer. Whereas in the other 7 patients out of that 100, they would have had a negative test, leading them potentially falsely to believe that they don't have colon cancer, and that's a little troublesome.
Bottom line to that would be, you need to follow the guidelines and have a colonoscopy on a regular basis.
Certainly when you're young, I think that's a good choice. Uh-huh. I think if you're going to look at Cologuard, you want to know necessarily what the right population would be. We know that the Cologuard test is FDA approved for patients who are considered average risk. So no prior history of colon polyps, no family history of colon polyps or colon cancer. At the same time, if you're young and you're healthy, you're 50, 55, you may still elect to do a colonoscopy because you might be able to tolerate that test a little bit better. If you're going to reserve a Cologuard, maybe for a patient who's in their mid to late 70s, isn't interested in doing a colonoscopy anymore, but has never had polyps before, that might be a target population to consider it in.